Sunday morning. here to this place today. I said, yes, God is here today. Amen. God is in the house today. Amen. And we need to worship and magnify Him because we are in the presence of the Lord. We have a long day on today. Amen. The missionaries will be going to Greater Northside. Amen. 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 For the annual missionary. Amen. 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 The missionaries will be singing.
Amen.
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 All right, now. This is our debut. Hallelujah. We on the road. Amen. First stop, Greater Northside. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. We're glad. Amen. We're glad to have a missionary choir. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. We're glad to be in the house of the Lord. Amen. At this time, we're going to go before the Lord in prayer. I ask you to remember all those who's not here on today. Remember the Ferguson family who had to leave. Amen. And all those who've been absent from us. Amen. We're asking you to remember Deacon Whippy. Amen. Amen. Remember him in your prayers. And all those who've been absent among us, amen. If you have any additional prayer requests, let them be known now. Sister Molden.
Country. I want to pray for those that are less fortunate than we are, the homeless, the hungry, the young people everywhere. We want to pray for my entire family and pray my strength in the Lord.
Amen.
I'm asking to pray for my family and the entire family. A special prayer for the Marco Makai and my parents. Asking to pray for Brenda Hayes and the Bowen family.
Amen. Remember, Sister Ashley, she had a concert this morning. Amen. God to bless her on this morning.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Deacon Holloway.
Amen.
Amen. Mr. Hope.
Special spoken request for Brother Reed.
Yes.
All the souls in the altar.
Amen. Amen. If there be no other requests, pass me not, O gentle Savior. Praise you, Lord Jesus, for that name, Jesus, is above every name, and that name every knees shall bow, and every tongue shall confess that you are Lord of Lords and hallelujah, God of all. My God, we thank and praise you today for knowing that name. Hallelujah, we ask you, Lord Jesus, for strength and mercy on today. Help us, O Lord Jesus, along this journey and along this way. We ask you to be our guide, Lord Jesus, our deliverer and our strength. Help us, O Lord Jesus, lead us in the path of righteousness for thy name's sake, Lord. That thy name may be glorified and magnified among the heathen. My God, we thank and praise you today, for you are worthy of all our praise. My God, we ask you to bless the service on this morning. Let thy spirit abide and dwell among your people. Lord Jesus, we ask you, Lord Jesus, to help us to decrease, that you might increase, Lord Jesus, that your will may be done. My God, we ask you, Lord Jesus, to bless this area, this neighborhood, that we're in, Lord Jesus. We ask you, Lord Jesus, to draw me into this place, to help us be a light, Lord Jesus, on this corner, Lord Jesus. Help us, Lord Jesus, to have willing hearts and a right mind. My God, bless your people in this place. Help us, oh Lord Jesus. Help our unbelief today. Help us to go from faith to faith. My God, take us from here to glory, Lord Jesus. My God, we ask you to help us to keep our minds stayed on thee. Lord, our mind is stayed on thee is in perfect peace. Remember our pastor on this morning and the first family. My God, bless them on every hand as they go and as they come. We ask you to help us to find favor, Lord Jesus, whatever they touch, my God. Let your love, hallelujah, follow them, my God. Remember Sister Ashley this morning. My God, and all those that's passing on today, for whatever reason, my God, we ask you, Lord Jesus, to keep them. My God, we thank and praise you today. We ask you to bless the service. Bless your word, my God. Help us not to be hearers only, but be doers of your word. My God, bless us as we go throughout this week. Help us to help somebody. Help us, oh Lord Jesus, to take our word wherever we go. My God, not to be ashamed of the gospel. My God, give us strength. Lord Jesus, hallelujah, to spread this word. My God, we ask you to bless this place, bless this service, and all the hallelujah to all that come in. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name. Come on, put your hands together and give God some praise. Hallelujah. Give God some praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, for he is here. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. My God, we ask you to remain standing and get your Bibles out. And say amen for Evangelist Ware as she leads us in our scripture reading. Let's say amen for her.
Amen. Psalm 65 in responsive reading. Psalm 65 responsibly. Amen. When you have it, say amen.
Amen.
Praise waiteth for thee, O God. In Zion and unto thee shall thy vow be performed. Iniquities prevail against me as for our transgressions, thou shalt purge them away.
Blessed the man whom thou choosest, and causest to approach unto thee, that he may dwell in thy courts. We shall be satisfied with the goodness of thy house, even of thy holy temple.
Thy terrible things and righteousness wilt thou answer us, O God, of our salvation, pour out the confidence of all the ends of the earth, and of them that are far off upon the sea.
Which by his strength setteth fast the mountains, being girded with power.
Which stilleth the noise of the seas, the noise of their waves, and the turmoil of the people.
They also that dwell in the uttermost parts are afraid of thy tokens. Thou makest the outgoing of the morning and the evening to rejoice.
Thou visitest the earth and watereth it. Thou greatly enrichest it with the river of God, which is full of water. Thou preparest them corn when thou hast so provided for it.
Thou waterest the fish thereof abundantly. Thou settest the pearls thereof. Thou makest all from showers. Thou blessest the springing thereof.
Thou crownest the year with thy goodness, and thy path drop fat.
May drop upon the pastures of goodness, and in the little hills rejoice every side.
13 altogether. The pasture are clothed with flocks. The valleys also are covered over with corn. They shout for joy. They also sing. Amen. The Lord of the blessings of the reading of his word. Can you shout hallelujah?
Hallelujah.
To our testimony service.
Thank you, Jesus.
And praise and thanks and honor and glory to that precious name.
Amen.
Praise the Lord, Sister Moldy.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
opportunity again in his house one more time.
Amen.
We all pray for you.
Can we say amen?
Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord, saints.
Praise the Lord.
I'm thanking and praising God today for being able to be here and not have gotten into any trouble through the weather. The weather is very bad.
Amen.
Probably didn't say that right. But I'm still thanking God for everything He has done for me.
Amen.
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 Amen. Praise the Lord, some color.
Oh, when I think of the goodness of Jesus, and all He has done for me, for my soul,
I'm holding up the blood stain.
Yes.
God has been good to me. Thank him for all the stuff that I see going on in the world. Just lets me know that God is soon coming.
Yeah.
Every time I hear stuff, I see it on TV, and it's like, how in the world can all these people that are in the world not think this, that there's something that's about to happen? Mm-hmm. God is going to come back for the church.
Thank you, Jesus.
How do I know? Because it tells me in the Bible.
That's right.
God has been good to me all down through the years. I'm getting to the place now where I'm getting to know God a little bit better all in right. my life than I did whenever I first came into Apostolic right. Church of Jesus, because I know what to look for. God has truly been a good working wonder in my life.
All right, all right.
Because he has made a way for me to be able to make it through. A lot of times I don't think or don't know if I'm going to make it. But he has made a way for me to make it.
All
and
right.
because he has made a way for me to make it, it helps me to hold on a little bit more.
Yeah.
And gives me something to hold on to because yeah. I know God is there working it out for me.
Yeah, right.
I read in the Bible somewhere where it says, you know, we have to sacrifice some things.
That's right.
That's how we get a chance to know who our Lord and Savior is.
Right.
We got to sacrifice
That's
some
right.
things. That's what helps us to draw closer to the Lord. We get to know him by the things that we grow through. And if we don't go through anything,
right.
we won't get to know him. It's like
That's
our
right.
Sunday school lesson this morning.
Thank
they
you.
Say, well, faith without works is dead.
Yeah.
And if you're coming in here and you're going to believe God for what he's doing for you, you got to show that you believe him by doing what you're supposed to
That's
be doing.
Right.
God said, I am the way, the
yeah.
truth, and the life.
That's what
no
he said.
Man cometh unto the Father,
Hallelujah.
But by me.
Praise
Amen.
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 Let's hear from our ushers. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. I'm thanking the Lord for being in this house one more time. I'm thanking him for waking me up each and every day and keeping me safe on the highways and the byways. As I was coming here this morning on Southfield, there were two cars, I guess, that had an accident, and then there was another car that was spent around
Thank
me and not driving safe.
Thank you.
They know the snow is out here. They know it was fresh, and they're still driving like there's no cares in the world.
Thank you,
God, because other people were backing up and going up the up ramp,
mm-hmm.
and it wasn't that serious. All they had to do was be patient and wait. And I'm just thanking God for keeping me
Amen.
On our way here, and I just pray that he continues to keep us.
Thank you, Jesus.
Every day. Pray
How would you
pray
do? Do we say amen?
Amen.
Praise the Lord, Brother Jason, you ever pray?
Amen.
Praise the Lord, our first lady, Sister Hope.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul, and all that's within me. Bless his holy name. I thank you, praise God, for another day of life. I thank you for salvation. I really thank you for his word and for the instruction that God has left. He's so precise, and I thank you and I praise him because it shows me how to order my life, how to walk, how to treat his house. I thank him because he gave specific instructions that were easy to follow. And all we have to do is follow his instructions
Amen.
To make it into glory. And I thank him and I praise him. The way it seems hard sometimes, but these are light afflictions that we're going through. We didn't have to carry the cross. Jesus already did that for
Hallelujah.
Us. But I thank him and I praise him because he's with us in every situation, every second, every minute, every hour
Amen.
Of the day. Jesus is with me.
Yes. Hallelujah.
I thank him and I praise him for
yes,
his
yes.
faithfulness, for his mercy, for his grace, for his
Amen.
Peace, for the joy, for the song, for the healing, for everything. Hallelujah.
Thank you.
All that I need, I find in Jesus.
Hallelujah.
All
right.
Hallelujah.
I'm just so grateful for the word that we have to read. God is so precise. In the things that he told Moses to teach the children of Israel. And it just makes me want to be in my place and to have things in order in the house of God.
That's right.
Because he's very particular.
Yes, he is.
God is very particular.
Amen.
And I thank him and I praise him because I'm trying to be particular. And I
yes.
thank him and I praise him because he gives me strength day by day.
All right, now.
I thank him and I praise him for his blood. I thank him because he can talk to you.
Yes.
Nobody can hear what he's saying to you.
Right. Yes.
Yes, Lord. Amen. I thank him and I praise him because he's a real God.
Yes, Lord. Hallelujah.
This is a real God
that we serve.
He's a living God. He's the all-powerful, all-knowing, all-present God.
Yes, Lord.
And I want to know him better. I want to know him better. Yes, we have to go through, but we don't have to go through by ourselves.
And
he said he will never leave us nor forsake us. So we can make it. We can make it. We can make it if we don't let go of God's hand, because he won't let go of ours.
Yes. Well, thank you. Yes. Yes. Shout hallelujah. I've got a feeling that everything's going to be all right. I've got a feeling everything's going to be all right.
Retreat 2014, the Epics. Apostolic Pentecostal Experience, hosted by the Northern District Council Pentecostal Young People's Union at the Radisson Hotel and Lansing Center in Lansing, Michigan, February the 28th through March 1st. Amen. This will take place on the 28th of March 1st. I believe all our young people are already registered. Amen. And looking forward to go. Guest speakers will be, amen, they have Sapp, Harris, and Tyson. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So this should be a good time in the Lord. Amen. He's the singer, amen, Marvin Sapp. Friday night at 7 o'clock, Saturday morning, I don't know who the Harris person is. And then Saturday night, Elder Tyson will be speaking.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Our announcements for the week. Monday night, our power
amen.
At 7 o'clock p.m.
Amen.
Amen. Wednesday night, Bible class at 7 p.m.
Amen.
Thursday night, choir rehearsal at 7 p.m. And on Sunday, everybody ought to go to Sunday school.
Amen.
The mama and the papa and the children too. Everybody needs to go to Sunday school. At what time?
9:45 a.m.
Amen. 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 And Sunday morning service at 11 a.m. Also, this afternoon, we'll be going over to Greater Northside, amen, their annual missionary services on this afternoon at 4 o'clock p.m., amen, we're asking all that can and come to support, amen, all the missionaries if you can, and the missionaries will be singing on this afternoon, amen,
amen,
amen. And the youth department invites you to follow along with us as we read the Bible in 1 year.
Amen.
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 Where are we?
Numbers 11, 12,
and
13.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. And if you don't, if you're not caught up, amen, they have a fund. Amen. A quarter, if you miss,
a day.
A day. Amen. And that has been beneficial. Amen. I don't know if that's still bad. We were able to, amen, register all our young people for this event. Amen.
Amen.
So, amen. That was a blessing. Amen.
Amen.
And we are on Facebook.
Amen.
Amen. AC Jesus Incorporated Online. Twitter us. Follow us on Twitter. Amen.
Amen.
We are on Ustream at AC Jesus and on YouTube. So you don't have to see us in person, but you can catch us on the internet. Come on, somebody. If you can't catch us in person, you can catch us on the internet. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. They used to have something to say, live or Memorex. Now we got live on the internet. Amen. Amen. I believe that's all the announcements. Amen. Also, don't forget missionaries. We will be having our first missionary meeting on the first Wednesday in March. Amen?
Amen.
First Wednesday in March. Amen. And don't forget VBS. We're expecting to have a good time. Amen. We're planning right now for Vacation Bible School. Amen.
Amen.
The second week in July. Amen.
Amen.
So and it's for all ages. Amen.
Amen.
All ages. Amen.
Amen.
So we're looking forward to that. These have been your announcements. Please govern yourself accordingly. Amen.
Amen.
At this time, we're going to call for the ACJ Voices of Praise.
Amen.
Amen. Voices of Praise. We ask them to come under the direction of Sister Sparkle.
Amen.
Amen. We ask God to bless you on this morning. Amen.
Amen.
Let's say amen for the Voices of Praise.
Amen.
I lift my hands in souls. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah.
move along the time.
Hallelujah.
We ask you to stand to your feet at this time.
Yeah.
Welcome the man of the hour.
Yes, yes.
Pastor Liz House.
Yes.
I'm Pastor Liz House. Yes. Yes. With a heart and praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
To trust in the Lord.
Right.
she works because she loves it. I know she came down supposed to meet the young people, but she did meet one of the young people last night. And she came, was it last night? Yeah, it was last night. Last night she came down to the church. We came down, because I don't want to come down here by herself. And the young people had their meeting, the things that they're going to have planned. It was just one. I told her, go ahead. Yeah, she was upset. She was upset because the young people don't seem like they want to do anything. But she said, I said, do it if you got just one. Do what you got to do. They don't want to work. Let them tell the Lord when they get there. And so she came on and she had, it seemed like they was having a good time out there. Having their meeting, planning their meeting, doing what they had to do. But we thank God for them. We thank God for Sister Sparkle this morning.
Amen.
She did a beautiful job in directing the choir. I had never seen her out there before, but she did a very wonderful job in stepping in and doing what she had to do. She came in the office, she was kind of scared. But we had prayer and she did a great job.
Yeah.
We're certainly happy to have our visitor.
Amen.
He's had the name of one of my friends that I was in the army with that I knew. We were childhood friends. His name is Tony Thompson. But we thank God for him being in the house of the Lord with us this morning. Now we're going forth in the word of the Lord. We have been talking about working on the building.
All right.
And we're still going to continue that theme today.
Amen.
Working on the building.
Amen.
And I want to go to 1 Corinthians, the 6th chapter, and the 9th verse.
All right now.
6th chapter of 1 Corinthians and the 9th verse. If you got it, say amen.
Amen.
We're still searching. Say, wait a minute.
Wait a minute.
1 Corinthians 6 and 9. Know ye not that the unrighteous shall not inherit the kingdom of God? Be not deceived. Neither fornicators, nor idolaters, nor adulterers, nor effeminate, nor abusers of themselves with mankind, nor thieves, nor covetous, nor drunkards, nor revilers, nor extortioners shall inherit the kingdom of God. And such were some of you. But ye are washed.
All right.
But ye are sanctified.
Thank you, Jesus.
But ye are justified.
Hallelujah.
In the name of the Lord
Jesus.
And by the Spirit of our God.
Thank you, Jesus.
Heavenly Father, we thank you.
Hallelujah.
We praise you and we magnify thy name. For thou art God and there is none else. The power and the glory belongeth unto thee. It is you that have brought us, and not we ourselves. Bless your word this morning. Help us to hear, help us to speak, and help us to receive in thy precious name, in Jesus' name. Amen. Our theme is working on the building. And last week, I spoke to you, even from Peter, and we talked about the lively stones. Peter called us the lively stones. God is working on the building.
All right.
Now, we talked about the quarry. When Solomon built the temple, his father David gave him the plans. gave him the measurements and all that should go in to the temple. He put it in Solomon's hands, that Solomon would build the temple. Now I want you to know something. The temple that Solomon built was a temporal building. It was a building that was going to be destroyed. A building that was going to be torn down. In fact, they had to build another temple after the temple in Jerusalem was destroyed.
Come on. All right.
And when they built the second one, they looked at it. They said, you should have saw the first one.
That's right.
Just to cut it short, they said, you should have saw the first one. Because it took something to build the first building. Mm-hmm. It took a lot of gold. It took a lot of stress. It took a lot of moving the stones and all.
Thank you.
And I told you that last week, that when they cut the stones out of the mountain, they smoothed those stones and cut them to spec. Mm-hmm. They had to be cut to spec. Mm-hmm. That when they brought the stones down to Jerusalem.
All right.
There was not a hammer, mm-hmm. a trial,
thank you, Jesus.
Any steel banging. There was no noise.
Thank you. Right.
While they built the temple.
Yeah, right. Yes.
When the temple came together, everything went in smoothly.
All right.
Into its place. I told you that God is building a temple. In the end, God's going to have his temple. And God has chosen other gods to help him. He has chosen the other gods to help him build this building.
Well,
I said, Elder Hope, you told us that there was only one God. One true and living God. In the 10th chapter of St. John, let me see where these other gods are. And who these other gods are that's helping Jesus build this building.
Well.
In the 30th verse, read for me, Sister Oak.
I and my Father
are one. Jesus said that he and God are the same person. He's just in the flesh. I and my Father are one. Now, I can't say that about my Father. Folks say I look like my Father. I've even passed the mirror and saw a reflection of my Father. But I cannot say I and my Father are one.
All right.
Jesus went further to say in that same book in the 14th chapter, he that has seen me has seen the Father. So here he tells the Jews, I and my Father are one. Now, you have to understand some things. First of all, the Jews have been expecting their God to come.
Well,
they have been looking for the God of glory.
Thank you, Jesus.
To come down and be with them and to set them on high.
Well, well.
Put them in the ruling class.
Thank you, Jesus.
That's their expectation. They were looking for a warrior God. But God did not come as a warrior.
That's right.
He came as a lamb.
Yes, all right, now. Hallelujah. Come on. Make it plain.
Great God that He is. He came as a sacrificial lamb.
Thank you, Jesus.
And they rejected Him because He didn't come like they expected Him to come. So when Jesus said to them, I am the one you've been looking for.
Thank you, Jesus.
Because that's exactly what He's saying here. I and my Father are one. Jesus is telling the Jews, I am the one you have been expecting.
All right.
And the Jews got very angry at Jesus. Read.
Then the Jews took up stones again to stone him.
Now, why would they stone the one that they're expecting? They stone the Messiah that they've been looking for centuries.
Well.
For millennia. Even since Moses told them that God would raise up a prophet like unto Himself. He said, hear ye Him.
All right.
So they've been expecting the Messiah a long time.
Yes,
now you have to understand that the Messiah is not just anybody.
Well, come on.
He's not just the Son of God.
But
He is God.
All right.
The power and the glory is His.
Yes, thank you, Jesus.
But He humbled Himself.
Yes, He did.
And became a man.
Yes. All right, now.
Now, it's the 14th chapter of Hebrew. Let me make sure of myself. Hebrew. It's not the 14th chapter. I got to get it right.
Thank you, Jesus.
Excuse me. It's the second chapter and the 14th verse.
All right.
He says, for as much then as the children are partakers of flesh and blood, He also Himself, that He is God, likewise took part of the same, that through death He might destroy him that had what?
The power
of death.
All right, come on.
That is the devil.
Lord.
Now the devil had the power of death. But he couldn't use that power over what God said.
All right.
His power was limited.
Come on.
In order to prove this point, I have to refer you to Job.
Thank you, Jesus.
When Jesus asked Satan, where you been? And he said, up and down in the earth, seeking. And Peter tells him what he was seeking. He was seeking whom he may devour.
And Jesus said,
have you considered my servant Job?
All right.
And he told him, you got a hedge around him so that I can't get to it. Move that hedge, and I'll make him curse you to your face.
Jesus.
See, Satan's threat has not ceased. he is still talking and working on the children of God to make them curse God.
Thank you, Jesus.
Some of you say, he's not going to make me cursing.
Watch out.
By the mere fact he can draw you away from God, tells me he's got the power to make you do what he wants you to do.
All right. Uh-huh.
He's not stupid.
Well,
he pulls you little bit by little bit away from God.
Yes.
He keeps drawing you. He keeps drawing you away from God.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Knowing that if he pulls you too quickly,
yes,
you might wake up and come back. But he's hoping that by the time you wake up, you so hung out, you can't get back.
All right, now come on.
But that's just how great God is.
Thank you, Jesus.
Going back. Well, let me just read this. It says, and deliver them who through fear of death were all their lifetime subject to bondage. For verily, he took not on himself the nature of angels. Now, wait a minute. Who took not on him the nature of angels? It is God. He didn't come as an angel. But he took on him the seed of Abraham.
Come on.
The seed substitute for the word nature of Abraham. So God took on a body to become a man. So it is very God that we are dealing with.
Thank you, Lord.
So when Jesus said, I and my Father are one, then the Jews took up stones. What?
To stone him.
Read, Sister Hope.
Jesus answered them.
Many good works.
Have I showed you
from my Father.
For which of those works
do you stone me? Now, he said, what good work? He ain't did no evil works.
Right.
So it's got to be for a good work.
Right.
That's how great my God is.
All right now.
It had to be a good work if you're stoning me.
Come on.
For what good work are you stoning me? Read.
The Jews answered him,
saying, for a good work,
we stone thee not,
but for blasphemy,
and because that thou,
being a man,
makest thyself God.
It is a sin. A sin to death for a man to call himself God. To put himself in the place of God.
Yeah.
He is subject to be stoned to death.
Come on.
And since the Jews did not believe Jesus, when he told them that he was who they've been looking for, they got upset.
All right.
They said, you got to die.
Oh,
and Jesus said, what did I do? When I tell you the truth, why are you stoning me? They said, you ain't told us the truth. They said, you lied to us.
Thank you, Jesus.
Being a man, make yourself God.
All right.
But see, they missed the mark.
Yes,
because he was not a man
yeah.
that made himself God.
Yes, all right, come on, say it.
But he was God.
Yes.
That made himself man.
Freak.
Is there anything
yes.
too hard for God?
Hallelujah.
Read, Sister Hope.
Thank you,
Jesus answered them.
Is it not written in your law?
I said. Wait a minute. He just called himself God again.
I said.
Ye are God. They missed it. They missed it. He called himself God right then and there. So now those gods that Jesus said are gods.
a people.
That's right.
Of the saints of God.
Yes, yes.
The Jews were the children of God. Now are we the sons of God.
Come on, come on.
And members in particular. So now we are the gods. In 1 Corinthians 3:9. Listen what Paul has to say. Read 3:9.
For we are laborers
together with God.
We are God's husband.
Ye are God's husbandman. Not husbandry.
Ye are God's building.
Ye are God's building. We are the building of God.
Come on, come on.
We are what we're working on.
Hallelujah.
We are what God
is
working on. That's how can we squirm when God begins to work on us.
All right.
Watch.
It's not easy for something that's alive.
Yeah.
For God to be worked on and not cry.
Come on.
I look at those that have themselves tattooed. And I understand that the tattoos hurt.
Yes.
Sticking the needle in you to have those tattoos put on.
Uh-huh. Thank you, Jesus.
But because they want the tattoo, they take the pain.
Yes. Well.
But when it comes to the saints of God, they refuse to take the pain.
All right. Come on.
But you got to be worked on.
Yeah.
Now, last week, I told you that when the stone was cut out of the mountain, that they worked on the stone, and some of those stones cracked.
All right, come on.
Some of them could not stand the stress.
Oh, well. Thank you, Jesus.
So the workers took those stones and threw them into the pile heap, where they throw all the stones that could not be used in the temple.
Come on.
But look at here. They couldn't use them in the temple. Because they were messed up.
Yeah.
They were right. So they were tossed aside.
Yeah. Well.
It looked like all their hope of being in the building was lost.
All right.
And I told you, you did not want to be thrown into the heap. When they cast off those stones that they could not use.
Thank you, Jesus.
But how great is God?
Yeah. Lord.
How wonderful is God?
Yes, Lord.
You see, when God went to the pile,
hallelujah,
that heap of broken stones.
Yes, sir.
He began to check them out.
Come on.
Because man had worked on the stone.
All right.
Come on. And when man worked on the stone,
it
was insufficient.
Hallelujah.
They could not bring it into spec.
All right.
They couldn't bring it into the place where it could be placed in the building. So when the master came into the quarry, he said, "What's that pile of stones?" Over there, they said, "That's the stones that could not use. He said, let me check it out.
All right, thank you,
And he began to pull out stones. And set them aside. Glory, hallelujah. He found some fornicators. Glory, hallelujah. They were all unrighteous. Some people try to set certain sins above another. Fornicating is all right in some people's eyes. Idolatry they can deal with. Adulterers they can deal with them. The effeminate, oh my God. Those homosexuals they begin to say, no. We ain't gonna have nothing to do with homosexuals marrying one another. But the fornicator is the number one.
Come on, make it plain.
And he's trying to stop the homosexual, which is the effeminate. Glory, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Lord have mercy.
Yes, Lord.
I want you to see that God, who is God?
Yes.
He's got all power in his hand.
Yes.
He came to save the whole world. Whosoever hears his voice and will come unto him. He'll make you all brand new. Glory,
hallelujah.
You can't come your way. You can't do it your way. Glory, hallelujah. But God's got a way. You can't get around it. God's got a way. You can't go under it. God's got a way. You must come in at the door. Glory, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Jesus said, I am the door to the sick folk. If you're going to get in, you have got to come by me.
Yes, sir.
Should have told. told you. Going to the heat pile is what we're talking about. Jesus going to the heat pile because he got some stones.
Thank you, Jesus.
That's been cast aside.
Thank you, Jesus.
Told that they weren't worthy to be in God's building. But God said, I'm a great God. I am the mighty God. My name is above every name. My name is the only name that's got power to save. Glory, hallelujah. And he went through the heat pile.
Well,
he found the idolater. The adulterer. The effeminate. He found the abusers of themselves.
Thank you, Jesus.
Of mankind. He found thieves.
Yeah.
He found covetous people.
Yeah.
He found some drunkards.
Yeah.
He brought some revilers.
Yeah.
Glory, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
He found some extortioners. He said, you shall not inherit the kingdom of God.
Well, well.
They were messed up. They fell in the heat pile. Glory, hallelujah.
Yes, Lord.
What was in the heat pile? What was already cut out?
Yes, sir.
Of the mountain. But when he cut it out the mountain,
come on.
The heat pile. Remember now, the stone is not a dead stone.
Come on.
But it's a lively stone.
All right.
Glory, hallelujah.
Make it right,
it's got feelings.
Yeah.
Glory, hallelujah.
Yes.
God's going to hurt somebody's feeling. Glory, hallelujah. And so God looked on him. He said, I washed this one. I cleaned this one. I filled this one with my spirit. And they fell away from me. But I'm coming back to claim my own. Glory,
hallelujah.
Listen to what he says. Read, Sister Hope.
And such were some of you.
Woo! Glory, hallelujah. He said, such were some of you. He said, you were some of them.
That's right.
You were in that heat pot.
Yes,
and I found you.
Hallelujah.
Listen what he said. That's for some of you.
But ye are washed.
But ye are sanctified.
But ye are justified.
In the name of the Lord Jesus. And by the Spirit of our God. God said, I saved you. You were drunken. Glory, hallelujah. Hallelujah. You went back and fell in the heap. You quit serving me. You quit obeying me. You quit doing things that will help you to be sanctified. He said, but I washed you. I filled you. Come out of the heap.
Bless him, Jesus. Bless him, Lord.
Bless him,
Lord.
He said, come out.
Come out.
You're mine.
Lord, thank you, Jesus.
You didn't listen to me the first time. You didn't obey me the first time.
Yes, yes, yes.
You listened to that old enemy.
Thank you, Jesus.
He threw you away from me.
Oh, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
He threw you till you didn't even know where you were.
Oh, forgive me, Lord.
And you began to lose confidence.
Yes, yes, yes.
in the word of God.
Yes, Lord Jesus.
He told you.
Have mercy, Lord.
Remember now, God is merciful.
Yes, he is.
He is a loving God.
Yes, he is.
And he will forgive you.
Yes, he is.
You don't have to go back right now. Glory, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
He said, you don't have to go back right now. Come on, have some fun. Stay with me a little while.
Jesus, Jesus.
Let's cut the step.
Oh,
on the floor.
Have mercy, Lord.
Me and you.
Oh, Lord.
And looked at them and said, oh, man, you sure look good to me. You were raggedy. You was nasty. You weren't dressed right. But he told you, you're looking good. Glory,
hallelujah.
He whirled you around on the floor. Glory, hallelujah. He whined and dined you. But along came Jesus. Along came the master. Come out. For the love of Christ,
strengtheneth us.
Stop. heat pile. Read.
Because we thus judge.
Because we thus judge.
That if one died for all.
That if one died for all.
Then we're all dead.
We're all no good.
That's right.
We were all no good. We were all in the heat pile. We were all cast aside.
That's right.
None of us was any good.
That's right. Mm-hmm.
Read.
And that he died for all.
In that he looked on us and had pity for us. He died for us. Read.
That they which live
should not henceforth live unto themselves. You see, folks that got God's stuff, they think God gave it to them for them.
Well,
this is mine. I got this myself.
Have mercy, Lord.
You're so ignorant.
All right.
That's not why you got it.
That's right.
Uh-huh.
That's right.
Amen.
You're going to pay for messing with God's money.
Have mercy, Lord.
You had to get in touch with Achan.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Back in Judges.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Find out what Achan had to say when he messed with God's stuff. That's what you're doing when you hold back God's money. You're due for death. When you don't pay your tithe and offering, that's a death sentence. Y'all ain't listening to me. I already preached the shouting message. I got to tell you what's holding you back. Because you should be running around church.
Hallelujah.
You should be speaking in tongues.
Hallelujah. Woo. Thank you.
Glory, hallelujah. Read, Sister Hope.
In that he died for all.
That they which live should not henceforth live unto themselves.
But unto him which died for them. And rose again.
See, what you got is not just for you.
All right.
God bless you to have it.
Yes, Lord.
But it's not just for you.
All right.
Amen.
You say this is mine.
Look out.
I got this. I worked on this.
Well done.
Ooh, glory, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Do I have to go to Deuteronomy?
Come on.
Glory, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Let the Lord.
He said, don't forget.
Don't forget.
Where all your blessings come from.
Come on.
He said, I didn't give it to you.
Mm-hmm.
For you to slobber all over.
All right.
He said, but I got a kingdom.
Yes, Lord.
I got a temple.
Yeah.
That I'm building.
Thank you.
I need the money.
Uh-huh.
To build my temple.
Yes, sir.
I gave it to you.
Yeah.
And you're not trustworthy.
Hallelujah.
I'm giving you another chance.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you.
I'm giving you a chance to repent.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank
you. Woo!
Hallelujah.
Let me get done.
Bless him, Lord.
Read, Sister Hope.
Wherefore henceforth. Know ye no man after the flesh. Yea. Though we have known Christ after the flesh. Yet now henceforth. Know we him no more.
Don't start. He said, don't keep looking at the flesh.
Right.
And what they did do. And how they did it. Right. Now that God stopped by and made a change in their lives, He touched them.
Yes, Lord.
Well, glory, hallelujah.
Yes.
And He fixed them.
Thank you.
Now when they come, don't look at them in the old manner of what they used to do. Look at them and what they're now doing.
Okay.
any man be in Christ,
he is a new creature.
Yes.
Old things.
Old
yes,
things
passed away.
Are passed away.
Hallelujah.
Behold,
all things are become
new. All things
yes, Jesus.
Are become new.
Yes, Jesus.
Great God Almighty.
Yes,
you know, I wish God would talk to me and tell me before I get in the pulpit what I have to say.
Well.
I'm studying another, and he takes me another. He said, now look. Look what I've done for you.
Yeah, Lord.
Look how I blessed you.
Yeah, Lord.
Read that one more time.
Yeah.
Wherefore?
Therefore.
If any man be in Christ,
he is a new creature.
Old things
are passed away.
Behold,
all things are become new.
Now, he said, I want you to change. It's time to change.
Mm-hmm.
He says, I already washed you in my blood.
Mm-hmm.
I already filled you with my spirit.
Mm-hmm.
I've given you instructions.
Yes,
now I want you to follow instructions.
All right.
You can't keep on doing me this way.
All right. Thank you,
God. You can't keep on ignoring me and telling me tomorrow.
All right.
I'll start tomorrow. He says, I want you to start today.
Come on.
I want you to start right now.
All right.
I want you to get it together right now.
Hallelujah.
Tomorrow.
Hey.
I wish I could sing that. Tomorrow. Thought about today, but tomorrow. Therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. Old things are passed away. Behold, all things are become new. He said, I'll make you all brand new.
Brand new.
If you'll repent today. If you repent today. If you repent today. If you start right now. He says, I'll forget about yesterday. And I'll look on you from today. I'll give you today to get it right. I give you today. Don't say but tomorrow. I'm talking to you today. Don't think about what you got to do. What you got to do is not in your hand. What you got to do, you got to believe God. I got to slow down. Read, Sister Hope. All things are of God. Nothing that you got, did you get it on your own?
All right, John.
Nothing that you have.
Well, nothing.
Can you keep it?
Nothing.
All right, say it, sir.
On your own.
Say it, sir.
You can't retain it. But I got mine fixed.
Yes, sir. Thank you, Jesus.
He says, I'll blow on it.
Yeah.
I'll blow on it. And it'll be nothing. It'll be nothing. What you trust in is nothing. That's your God. It belongs to me. And I'm giving you a second chance.
Thank you, Lord.
Really? I'm giving you a 4th, 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th, 10th, 12th chance.
Tell it. Come on.
To get it straight.
Yeah, thank you, Jesus.
Don't get smart on me. All things are of God. Who have what?
Reconciled
us. That's the church. Us is the church. That ain't every church. That's us. That's every church that's washed in his name.
Yeah, sir. Make it plain, sir. Make it plain.
Not everyone is washed in his name.
That's right.
All of them don't know his name.
Well,
they think he's three.
Well,
but he said, I'm just one.
I'm just one.
He said, I'm God.
Yes,
all by myself.
Yes,
all
that's my
43 and 10. None before me.
Yes,
None after me. None beside me.
All right now.
He said, I'm God.
I'm God.
He said, I was born in Bethlehem, Judea. Woo! Glory, hallelujah.
Jesus.
Read, Sister Hope.
All things are of God.
All things are of God. Who has reconciled us to himself.
By Jesus Christ.
When you were down in Jesus' name, Jesus reconciled you to himself.
Right.
Read.
And have given to us
the ministry of reconciliation.
To wit
means to know.
That God was in Christ.
Jesus had the fullness of the Spirit in him.
Yeah.
For in him dwelleth all the fullness of the Godhead bodily.
You preach it now.
Glory, hallelujah. To wit, that God was in Christ. Read.
Reconciling the world.
Unto himself. God's doing it.
That's the word. That's right. That's the word.
He didn't say my son. He said God.
Yeah.
God did it. Read.
Not imputing their trespasses.
He won't charge you with those trespasses. He won't charge you if you give them up. If you turn away from them, he'll fix it. Read.
Have committed unto us.
And will not compute their trespasses unto them, and have committed unto us the word of reconciliation. He says, I'll fix it so you can tell others how great I am.
All right.
I'll fix it.
Hallelujah.
So you can praise me.
Yes.
I'll fix it.
Amen.
So when they see you coming,
yeah,
you'll be walking in a new step.
Glory.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The light will be shining bright. They're going to ask you, what's wrong with you? You're going to say, what are you talking about? You can't see the light. But they are seeing the light. Shines in darkness.
Yes, Jesus.
How great the light.
Hallelujah.
How great the light.
Hallelujah.
That shines. In the dark place.
All right.
The world is a dark place. Folks are trying to invoke God.
Yes.
And they don't know God.
Yes.
We are his people.
That's right.
Called by his name.
Right.
His name is above every name.
That's the word.
There's no name.
No name.
That can attain unto his name.
All right.
His name is the only name
that
has salvation.
That's right.
His name, not some other.
Uh-huh.
You got to have his tag.
All right. Yes, sir.
You got to receive
his
stamp of approval.
All right. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah.
What a mighty God we serve. He is the great God.
Oh, thank you, Jesus.
He is the living God. I got to stop. I'd like to go home.
Thank you,
Jesus. But my body won't let me.
That's good.
My body won't let me.
All right.
I'm hoping God give me some strength one day.
Thank you, Jesus.
So I can tell the world just how great God is. But mainly the saints. Those that have walked away from God. Those that have gotten angry with God and said it ain't worth it. Let me call it like it is. You're stupid.
All right. You're talking good.
There ain't a man.
Come on.
There ain't a woman.
Come on.
Good enough for me to walk away from God.
That's right. Say that.
Not a one. To give up on God for a man or a woman, that's stupid.
Yes,
he It'd be better for me to go through this life by myself than to get the one, that howling woman.
That's the Bible said.
Well, I have to live in the rooftop.
Oh,
y'all don't know what I'm talking about.
Yes,
since y'all don't read. All things are ready. We have the great and the living God. One that's able to save and to deliver.
Thank you, Jesus.
One that has made the way out of no way.
Yes, yes.
Brought us out of darkness.
Thank you, Jesus.
To his marvelous light.
Yes. No.
We are workers together with Christ. Uh-huh. He needs some more stones in his building. And he'll make room for you.
Thank you, Jesus.
In his building. If you're here today and you'd like to be part of the building, there are some requirements to be a part of the building. You must repent and be baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ for the remission of your sins. And he will fill you with the gift of the Holy Ghost. You've got to be. To even get started, you got to repent. You that have already been there, you got to repent. If you've already been to the water in Jesus' name, and you walked away from it, you got to repent. You said, I didn't walk away from it, so I ain't going nowhere. Yes, you did. And you know you did. That's how come God sent the word. He know you walked away. The devil told you it was silly. You ain't got to give your money to the church. You work hard for them. That's a sin. If you think I'm lying, go read Judges 5. Go read Judges 5. Somebody said tithing is under the law. That's another lie. Tithing comes from Abraham. Abraham was 400 years before the law. We are of our father, Abraham. We're not of Moses. We're of Abraham. We're of the faith of Abraham. In other words, we got to do what Abraham did. He paid his tithes. He gave what belonged to God to him. If you're here today, we got clothing for men, women, and children. We got water, clean water. We got somebody to baptize you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Not Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. That's not a name. But in the name of the Father. The Father's name is Jesus. And of the Son. The Son's name is Jesus. And of the Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost's name is Jesus. So we baptize in Jesus' name. We go to Luke. The 24th chapter. He said repentance and remission of sin should be preached in his name beginning at Jerusalem. If you're here today, all things are ready. The clothing is ready. Someone's here to help you change your clothes. The water is ready. We will baptize you in his precious name. Are you here today? Will you come? Will you allow the Spirit of God to touch your heart, to move in your spirit? He will fix it for you. He'll fix it if you allow him to fix it. He'll fix it. Will you come? Sing it one more time. Ordered the envelopes are ready, and we forgot to go get it.